You're just about to lose a very excellent secretary.
You're out of your mind.
Yes, I think I am a little. I'm a girl who's waited a long time for this to happen to her. And now it has. Mr. Jefferson doesn't know it yet. But I'm going to try my darndest to marry him.
Is that all?
Well, yes, except that, well, I suppose this is my resignation as soon as you can find someone else.
Now, listen to me, Maggie. We've been together a long time. You are indispensable to me, but I think that I'm unselfish enough not to let that stand in the way where your happiness is concerned. Because whether you know it or not, I have a deep affection for you.
Oh, I know that, Sheriff.
That being the case, I will not stand by and see you make a fool of yourself.
Oh, but I'm not.
You are, my dear. You're behaving like Tilly the Toiler. Oh, it's incredible.
I don't know how it's happened, Sherry. I can only tell you that it has. It's hard for me to believe myself. Here I am, a hard-bitten old cynic, behaving like Winnie the Pooh and liking it. Discovering the moonlight and ice skating and...
We're leaving here tomorrow. Hip or no hip, we are leaving here tomorrow. I don't care if I fracture the other one. You get me a train schedule and start packing. I'll pull you out of this, Miss Stardust. I'll get the ants out of those moonlit...
It's no good, Sherry. It's no good. I'd be back on the first streamlined train.
Oh, it's completely unbelievable. Can you see yourself the wife of the editor of the Massalia Journal? Having an evening at home for Mr. and Mrs. Stanley, Mr. and Mrs. Dribblepuss, and the members of the Big Sisters Benevolent Association.
Sherry, I've had 10 years of the great figures of our time, and don't think I'm not grateful to you for it. I've loved every minute of it. They've been wonderful years, gay and stimulating. I don't think anybody's had more fun than we've had. But a girl can't laugh all the time, Sherry. There comes a time when she wants... Bert Jefferson.
Oh.
Oh, you don't know Bert, Sherry. He's gentle, and he's unassuming, and he's... Well, I love him, that's all.
I see. Well, I remain completely unconvinced. You're drugging yourself into this Ginger Rogers fantasy, and before you become completely anesthetized, I shall do everything in my power to bring you to your senses.
Now, you listen to me, Whiteside. You lay off. I know you. I know what a devil you can be. I know what you've done to other people, but you're not going to do it to me. And don't you drug yourself with the idea that you're only thinking of my happiness. You're thinking of all those months of breaking in somebody new. I've seen you in a passion before when your life has been disrupted. And you couldn't dine on July 12th in Calcutta with the Maharaja this or that. Well, that's too bad, Sherry. But there it is. I'm going to marry Bert. If he'll have me. Don't you pull any of your tricks on me, because I'm onto every one of them. That's my message to you. Big Lord Fauntleroy.